Hello, hello. Today I'm going to show you an awesome unboxing video by me for you. Today, let me introduce you the Launch C-Reader 3001. It is an OBD2 scanner. EOBD Car Fault Code Reader. OBD Professional Automotive Diagnostic Tool for DTCs check. Engine Light Scan Tool. It supports the O2 sensor, the EVAP system. It's a powerful compatibility support. And it supports OBD2 and EOBD protocols. It works on most 1996 US-based and 2000 European-based and Asian cars. And newer OBD2 and CAN domestic or import vehicles. It supports English, German, French, Spanish, Italian, Russian and Portuguese. Plug and play, I say to you. It does not require any battery for charge. Just need to connect the diagnostic cable into the vehicle's DLC socket. The Launch CR 3001 can be powered and used immediately. The OBD2 full function, IM readiness, status test, view freeze frame data, view data stream, O2 sensor, EVAP system test, onboard monitoring test, read and clear DTCs, identify the VIN, vehicle identification number, and some other informations. Read DTCs, DTC code, lock up, turn off, MIL. The MIL is a malfunction indicator lights, and this is not so nice light in your car, because if these lights pop up, you have a little fail function. Then you can use this kind of tool and you have a look for the fail function. And then you can replace a part or repair your car, and after you've done the reparation, then you are able to set the car to a normal function. Turn check engine light off. Quickly read and restore emission related codes, panning codes and show code definitions. Turns off the MIL, the check engine lights, help in resetting the monitor before taking it to smog. Plus, it tells you what is going on before bringing the car in for a repair in a garage. Saves you the trips to your mechanic. Classic and portable design, built with a large LCD display, 160 to 128 dpi, equipped with a 2.5 feet long cable and made of a very thick flexible insulator. There are four buttons on CR3001, the up and down button for scrolling the menus, the OK and the exit button allows to enter menu and navigation back, portable size allows you to carry around on your trip. And it's really easy, and it is not so expensive, so this thing can make an easy diagnostic with you and for you. The check engine light is part of your vehicle's onboard diagnostic OBD system. Computers have controlled the monitor vehicle performance. Regulations such variables as engine speed, RPM, fuel mixture, and ignition timing, and may even tell the automatic transmission when to shift. When the electronic control system finds a problem, it cannot adjust. The computer turns on a yellow warning indicator and stores a trouble code in its memory. That diagnostic trouble codes help identify the problem source of your car, such as a malfunctioning sensor or a misfiring engine, and can be read with a scan tool or a diagnostic computer. Vehicle manufacturers originally used the OBD system to help technicians to get their jobs done faster and easier. Exactly, that the OBD system locks off depends on the make, models and year of the vehicle. As everybody who has a car knows, People always spend hundreds of even thousands of dollars on their vehicle just because the engine light was on. The easiest way to raise it to check the engine light and clear the codes is to use a scan tool, which plugs into the OBD2 DLC port, usually somewhere on the driver's side. Check your own manual for the location. For DIY service, you do not need to invest in a top-of-the-line scan tool for basic diagnostic function. So let's go and have a look how it works. So we are standing on the left side of your car. We're going to open this door, and now we have to search for the OBD2 spot and the hub of the OBD2 on your device, on your vehicle. So we have to dock this device into it. So in case of Audi, it is here. Here are the pedals of your clutch, brake and acceleration, and here you can see that it is. This is the OBD2 hub, and there we can dock in this device. Do this at the right direction, and if you docked it, you can see the OBD2 scanner will boot immediately. Here we are. Now we are at the main. Let's go, and to change the language first, let's go to Hilfe in this case. Then we have tool informations. There are the tool informations. Okay, let's go back. Tool Einstellungen is what we are going to need. Sprache is language, so let's switch the language to English. Good job. Now we are on English. Tool setup. Yeah. Now we are able to set the unit of measuring. Here we can see metric or impera. Go back, language, okay. Then we can see the help file. The help file give us information about the OBD2, the data stream, the IM, and the tool information. Let's have a look on OBD. What is OBD? What is OBD2 modes? Vehicle coverage. Let's have a look. Oh, here is some information about this. This is nice. Go back with this back slide button. And now we are at the main menu. Tool setup, help. What was tool setup? Our language and measuring, okay. Now we can get into the system by setting the ignition on. You do not have to start the engine, only start the ignition. Then you can see the energy is getting into the machine, but the engine is not working. Yeah, but this is important because of the live data and the electronic compounds inside. So let's have a look. Main menu, diagnostics. Let's go to enter into the system, into the system of your car. And we are now getting into it and have a look here. This is a monitor status. No DTC in this ECU. No failure codes. This is nice. Red lines okay. Red lines incorporated. Red lines NA. Data stream count, etc. We can go up and down with these buttons. And then if you read codes, you can see what failure codes will give your vehicle to you. The vehicle has no failure codes. Oh, this is good. But if you have some fault codes, you will see here some information about this. For example, ignition coil is damaged. Now replace the ignition coil, then sit down and read again, and then the failure code is still there. First, after the ignition cords are replaced and now they are still working, we have to delete the failure code. For this, go to the diagnostic menu and then erase codes. Then clear, reset emission related information. Are you sure? Okay. Now,
You have to turn the ignition on with the engine off, press enter the key to continue. Here it is, what I said before. And if you did this, you can switch to OK and then all failure codes are deleted. And this is, for example, the engine. A light will switch off immediately after this. So, OK, now it has been cleared. Good job. And what's more here? I am read lines. Let's have a look there. Here you can see, since DTC cleared, this drive circle, let's go into it, and here we can see some live information. It is, everything is okay, good job. Now go back, for example, data stream, let's have a look, get supported data stream loading, and here we are, and these are the live datas. Now it's everything is zero. ECT is 45 degrees Celsius. Now let's start the engine, for example. I will start it. So here we are. And let's have a look. Engine is still running. And here is the load PCT, nearly 40%. Now I will get a little bit gas into it. And here you can see it is different. Okay, let's go to next side. Here, for example. Here, rounds per minute, 900. Now I will give her a little bit acceleration, and you can see until 2000. Yeah, MAP, 35 kilopascal. Everything is live on the screen here. This is nice. I like this. O2S11. Here you can see how much voltage. O2S12, etc. Everything is there. Good job. I like it. Freeze frame, O2 sensor test is available, onboard monitoring, evac system, and the vehicle information. Let's go to the vehicle information, and I can switch off the engine now. So, here we can see the vehicle information, VIN, vehicle identification number. This is important to get some tools, etc. DTC lockup, and, here we are back in the menu, in the main menu. Oh, let's go back into it. Sorry about this. This is a back button. This is the OK button, up and down. And if you push twice this back button, you will come back to the main menu, of course. So let's head back into it. I have to switch on the ignition. Oh man, what's this here? Oh no, no, no. And now we are getting into it. Here we are. Here's the information about this. Let's go down. Here we are. Here we are. Onboard monitor, vehicle information. So, get supported data, VIN loading. So you can see CID. This is a CID of my car. CVN. This is a CVN of my car, for example. And this is awesome, and it's cheap, and it is a small product, and it will get you information about your car and your failure codes. This is awesome. To get out of it, go back until are you sure to exit diagnostic function. Okay, now we are back in the main menu, and we are going to plug off the device, and then we finish this diagnostic style. I like it really much. This should be in every car out there, up to 3.5 liters, I think. Not trucks are supported. And that it is. I hope you liked it. I am liking this device. It's really nice. This will help you in trouble. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe me and give me a positive feedback. And I hope to see you again on my channel. Soon.